Hello everyone. So today I would like to share my expression about this online C++ conference, CPCon 2012. The program. So first there was 3-day pre-conference classes. Then we have welcome session, then we have 1 week with basic session, after it we have feedback session, and after it we had 3-day post-conference classes. Pre-conference classes was about TDD, advanced and memory C++ programming, management memory, modern design pattern, modern C++, and about concurrency and system architecture. So I was visited only about concurrency. There was author of very popular book, The Concurrency in Action. And post-conference classes was about concept, parallelism, C++ 17, STL, programming on GPU and modern C++. So I was on about GPU. There was author of very popular library, its wrapper of OpenCL and basic track. One moment. Yeah, and was basic track. There was a lot of group of speech. For example, it was about algorithm, compiling and tools, concurrency, design, and other. And each day we have schedule, and each participant can choose what topic is more interesting and add in his schedule. It uses this tools SCAD.com, and it pretty was convenient. And as you know, all conference is online, so we use remote online platform where we have online tables and can join to each table and see each other, like face-to-face meeting when you go to some table in conference. It was pretty funny. And when topic was started, it was shared for all participants. There was a lot of presentation, and all topic was important. So review all topics, it will take a lot of time, but we have only 1 hour for this presentation. And I choose that only main points of each presentation and pay attention to practice, not theory. So Monday, we have presentation about primitives, abstract machine, new in Visual Studios, solid, memory mapped, templates programming, and structural programming. So I decided to choose topic about primitives and new in Visual Studio. And it was first part, and second part was about collaboration with Visual Studio Code and future of parallelism, calling function, move semantic, about iterators, class load, just in time compilation, and test driving. I decided to choose about Visual Studio Code and move semantic. So let's start with primitives. Author was Brian Strastrup. What was problem? We have message and message can is written by some logic, and we have some logic that reads this method, this message, and its logic can be in different technologies, use different languages. For example, we have C++ business logic, we have some logic that translate some message in bytes, and we have Java that reads in these bytes, and we have also business logic on Java. So how to decide how message should be? It helps interface definition language. When we can type this, we have pair and we have name, it's string, and some value that is int, so they will take 8 bytes. No, it's similar like int std int 32. So how it works? We have interface definition source that generate some code in specific language, for example, C++ or Java, and we have code that work with this message, like loud that work with this message and with some our business logic. For example, also the view, what is it? For example, we have some message, we have members of these messages, and we don't need all members of these messages. We can create view and say that we also need like float of string of specific members. And how it generate in C++? So we have example of in interface definition language, and we have generated C++ code. It's pretty similar. And how it will be access or write on utilization? We have value, we have method value, we can set new value, we have method names, then we receive value of some names, and also we have method names when we have set a new value. So next topic is about new in Visual Studio. So we have several parts, like some improvements that related to comforts, code safe, cross-platforming, and developer NT productive. This speech was about Visual Studio 29, version 60.8. There was implemented this Visual Studio support crunch times, modules, and you can visit GitHub and see which feature is implemented how many features is not implemented yet. So let's see example how work crunch times in Visual Studio. We see CLD and we for example, this example about Fibonacci, and we have while loop when we call yell, and now we locate it to this call yet, and next we continue when we come back to this loop, we continue debug, and we see that in debug we have core frame Peter when we can see value of some variables, and debug when it was called. Also, there was added statistic analysis about crunch times, and we see that we have some warning about local variable. And also it works when we add std mutex, we see and new warning. How to set up this warning? In Visual Studio, we was added a set of rules. And for example, these concurrency rules. All, if you need all rules, you can choose Microsoft all rules. Also in Visual Studio was added concept. And statistic analysis understands this concept, and you can see hits of some concept. Also was added module. It's example of simple modules. And if we click to the definition, we can find all definition of this module. Also, if we need add module, Visual Studio, we choose model interface unit, and it was added, and Visual Studio will be understand. So what was improved? What was improved about static analysis? Was added client TD, was added studio code linters, and support work sponsors about package manager VSC package. We if we open CMake file, we will see warning that package is not installed, and static analysis understand it, and you can install package from Visual Studio. Also, as I said, was improved understands CMake syntaxes, and we can choose some variable, click find definition, and we'll find when all definition of this variable. Also was added support synthesize. If we in CMake add this variable, then run test, and we see some test is failed. And we, if we go to test, we see output per each test. It's pretty convenient. Also in debugging, we see more convenient error in GUI. Also was added live sharing. What is it? You can share your session with other person and together debug same solution. Also was improved support Linux. You can see that in CMake we have several targets, and it's pretty convenient to debug in Linux. Also was added support build inside. You can see what takes time when during compiling. Also, so next topic about Visual Studio code. In Visual Studio code was improved work with CMake. You can type CMake and find some action that related to CMake. For example, select variant and we choose which configuration we will use, debug release. Also was improved support we see package. We when we run Visual Code, this will be automatically installed. Also, it was improved work on Linux. You can see you can open SSH session, and now we run on Linux, and we see that on Linux these tools will be installed automatically too. Also, we can debug in Linux, and there we use Linux. We use GTPG debugger, and we see all variables, and it works pretty well. Also, Visual Studio Code support for port forwarded port. It's pretty convenient. So let's start without how to create container when in from Visual Studio Code. So we type remote container and choose add development container configuration file. So this Visual Studio Code will generate some files. First file is dev container, when you can set extension for Visual Studio Code and will be generated doc file when you can type some settings too. And you see that we run this, you see that we work in container and it's pretty convenient. So next about live sharing. you choose live sharing and click start collaboration session and it will generate some link. In next machine, you click join collaboration session and copy paste the link. So we have two machine, Windows and Mac, and we can debug together too. So next topic is about move semantic. So we have methods that accept string, and we see that when we use more, when we call insert and get string, it's called move, and we have same link to each. We have same address of variable. So, but when we add const get string, so it wasn't be work because it will be create new copy. So don't return by const value if value will be used in move semantic. Next example is insert with the move. So we see that value will be was moved and we have same address. But when we add const to value to variable, so we see that we have new address. And if we add const string, so it doesn't help because we just said that this value will be not modified. So next example about vector. So we have class, we have template class, and this class has a vector inside. This is also template. So we create this string and it works pretty ok, but when we work with Boo, we have specific implementation with Boo, and using key loop, it's not good because object of loop can be a temporary proxy object. So about Boo, it will be not work. How it fix? It better use universal reference, and with Boo it will be work. About getter. As you know, when we return value, it's very expensive because we return copy of value. How we usually work, we use reference and it works, but it doesn't work in loop when we return in template object and it can be a curl dump. How to fix? We can return value only for objects that might be dead. So we use an universal reference and use move. So, and it works. Next day had a lot of topics. So like topics about pointer members, building an intuition of composition, about a member developing physical units library for next C++, about synthesizers, about C++ 12, templates, dynamic memory, current times, about Rust and C++. And next part was about template, evolution of function and current times, also about remembering limitation and C++ STL features. Sure. So I decide to choose a topic about physical units library and C++ 12 and also C++ 12 STL future. So let's start with physical units library for C++. What is library? This library is very convenient when you work with some physical units. For example, and it works in compile time. So we can write static assert and divide 10 kilometers and it will be equal 5 kilometers. It's GitHub repository of these units. And also you can use this library in Compile Explorer. You can install this library using Conan, pretty easy. And what is similar libraries? One of the libraries is Boost Units, but it's hard to include all headers and it's very complicated to understand what is compile error. So next time, next library is Nick Holtzels. I hope I pronounced correctly. It's pretty convenient library, but it doesn't work in compile time. But also this library support concept, and this library support concepts too. And as you know, this library work in compile time, so code of this library will be pretty simple and it's have good performance, which compilable is support. It's work on GDC, Visual Studio, but unfortunately it doesn't work on Lang. So next about C++ 12. So what was added in the new version of C++? New keywords like concept, cover, return, new identifiers for import, modules. So let's go with module. We see a simple example of module when we export module and its main file, we import the module. Was added the ranges. So for example, we have vector when and we want to filter value vector, transform value, drop some some elements and run transform. So it's pretty visible syntaxes. It's similar like pipe in Linux or some Unix systems. And it's very convenient. It's so also was added coroutines and it's example of generator sequence. So we create a generator and we have loop that take each value of the generator. So it's pretty convenient. And was added concept. It's example of very simple example of concept, and we can use concept in templates. Or instead of templates, we just set in function instead of type, just concept. And some changes about lambda. Before C++ 20, compute this was implicit. So since C++ 12, it's explicit. So you need capture this. So was also was added templated lambda, and instead of type using type name, we can just write templated Lambda. Also was improved about shared pattern. Now it's more safe, and also was added atomic shared pattern. I have tried this run this function. Unfortunately, now it's work only in Visual Studio, but it's pretty convenient. Just store your object in atomic. Also was added gthread. Why it was added? So the extruder automatically call join, and it wasn't crashed when you forget to call join. Also was added stop token. It's pretty it's more convenient to stop your thread of instead of using some variable or some mutex or something else. And also was added semaphore in C++ trend, and there are two types of semaphore: counting semaphore and binary semaphores. Also was added latches and barriers. We don't have a lot of time. You can Google it and go next. So also was added a spaceship operator. In C++ 70, we should define a lot of operators, but now we just use spaceship operators and minimize code. Also was added range-based for loop initialization. So we can initialize value in loop and use this variable during this loop. Also was added calendar and time zones. So we can create data pretty easy. Just type year, months, a day. So next topic was about C++ 20 ESL feature. There was added a lot of context algorithms. For example, we can check is sorted in compile time. Also was improved delete some elements of container. Before we used some remove if where else, but it can be we can make bug or it will it was slowly. So now was added just erased if we put container and some functor that decide which element will be delayed. Also was added atomic ref, and as you seen, we have some variable. We need to say before call some thread, and after thread we have value that was modified during several threads. Also was added container span. What is a container? They stored only count and reference to value. It's similar like string view, and we can put any containers, and it's not just template, it just we type container span and it works for all containers. Also, you can see what feature is implemented in Visual Studio or no, just follow by this link. So go to next day. Next day was about Lambda architecture, allocator allocations, polymorph, quick testing, Qt applications, about performance, just time compilation and exploration of C++ 20 metaprogramming. And also it was about cross-platform, unit test, remote work with CodeSpace, string formatting library, about algorithm but no, basically about algorithms, about threads, reference parameters, design patterns, and algorithms. So let's start this topic about testing Qt and application using approval test. So how usually we test? We have execution. We move some code in the static library and make execution that run test using the static library. Why is a static library? No, it's easier than shared library, and we don't need some code changes like when we move in dynamic library. So this presentation about Google test, about Qtest and Catch. So how test Qt application using Catch? So we should add, define, include Catch, and run Catch session and put some arguments from main. For example, we should test color picker, and be sure that it works fine. How we test? We create color widget, we create accepted color, and check if it works. How we test when we how we test signals? So we create signals spy and create some clicks on some widget and check value of this widget. And one of the recommendation is to use text fixture instead of directly check value of widgets. And now test will be more convenient or more readable. What's problem when we use when we need test Qt application without GUI? So usually in Windows it works. For Linux we can use virtual display or use some flags, or we can use some macros that decide we use GUI or no. So let's go to approval test. It's library that make testing more convenient or easy. So it includes Qt test and Catch 2. How to change our test? So before our main was like defined some macros include catch, and we can change like define approval catch Qt and include some headers. And for example, we want to check this visual, it's like table. And how it will be test? It was like usual test, we can widget, we run some logic, but instead of checking, we run approval test Qt and verify table. And we run approval test, we will have two files and follow approval test. And while one file is approved file and a second file is received. So received is a file when we have a result of test. Like output, and approval it's our accepted result. So if we compare this file, we see that approval file is empty and accepted it's our current result. So we copy paste this value to approval test and rerun test, and we see that test passed, and in folder approval test we have only one file. So it's pretty convenient to test your logic. And other tools for test GUI is Squish, but it's commercial tools. So next topic was about cross-platform. What we have? We have several build system like make, Xcode, Microsoft build, and some build systems that generate code for build system like QMake, Mason, CMake, and other. And the most popular is CMake. What's the problem with CMake? First of all, it's not familiar syntaxes for C++, and it's difficult to find best practice about CMake. So let's see some example of using CMake. CMake have building tools, like you can create folder, create link, and something else. And it's a recommendation to use building a command instead of commands that related to platform. Like, for example, we should create some link, and in my Windows, we should call mklink, but in Unix, we can use other command, but it's more convenient to use building command in CMake. And also, it's a recommendation to use target compile feature instead of add some flags in global variable. And other problem in the cross-platform developing is package manager. We can use built-in package manager in system like in Ubuntu, the apt, or some specific package manager like NuGet, or use specific language specific packages like Conan. So let's go to work with CMake. And in Visual Studio, when we run project, when we run configuration of project, we see errors that some package wasn't installed. So we open, we see package.json and add dependency of some packages. And when we run configuration on project, we see that some package will be installed automatically, and some project will be compiled specific on this platform. Also, in Visual Studio was implemented supports CMake syntaxes, and we can see where the variable is set. For example, in this variable, we see that the variable have several files. And when we add some files, Visual Studio try to detect in which target you would like to add, and it will be generate some code or try to automatically add file to new variable. So what's problem with debugging? When you switch to other platform, you are not familiar with tools that is using in a specific platform. And also you can use graphical interface or command line. How it can be resolved? You can use cross-platform IDE like Qt Creator, Visual Studio Code, or use remote debugging like remote debugging and add some extensions to your IDE, like for Visual Studio Remote Extension or CLine and Qt Creator support without any exception. So how work with Visual Studio? So we have some example on GitHub Codespace, and we see that we runned some application in the GitHub Codespace, and we have output of the application and terminal. So how we work in Visual Studio? We can click connect to Codespace, set link to repository, choose instance, and we see that we remotely run application in our machine. Also, we can remotely debug our code using Visual Studio. Let's so next topic about formatting library in C++ 12. So in C++ type was added as the format. It's pretty safe than was like in C or something else. And it's pretty easy. We can just type hello CPP and use request and put value. So we can use placeholder, or we can set position of our value. Also, we can use some specific format. General format, it could be a lot of parameters. Let's go with parameters. So first parameters is this. We can set this in our format string, or it will be value out our parameter string. And also we can set a link. If we can link our value like left, right, or bytes center, and set separator during our filling space. Also, we can set things like display, plus or minus, or use default settings. Also, we can use several format like binary, hex, and other formats. And also we can use float pointer when we can set how much number after dot. And also when we use binary format or hex format, we can identify show zero and begin or no. And also it support locate. We can set locate USA or something else, and it will be formatted according to locate. If we have error during formatting, it will be printed exception, and it's more easy to handle some errors instead of checking some code. So next day was about CLAN, smart points, multi-thread, modern C++, security, range, and full asynchronous OS based on C++. And was about cost of void, design patterns, using class interface to generate test, move semantics, OS OPP, unit test, and other tools. So let's go with CLI. So what was added in CLI? We, for example, we have class and we have generate constructor. Call generated, and we see how it will be generated. So we can also generate equal operators, and we can choose which variable, which member will be used in this operator. We see generated operator, and also we can set, we can click checkbox, use the type, and we will generate using the type. What was added in CLI? Also, it was added storage, not only by class file and also in action. For example, if you forget where to locate it in menu, you can just put local history, and it's easy to find some action. And was improved compared with code. You can directly see your history in your repository. So let's talk about fuzzing testing. What is it? So for example, we have some container, and we want to test how it will work with a lot of data. So we should test each parameters, and it's too hard. What is more convenient way? So we have some fuzzer engineer that generate a lot of strings and call some method. And if it's valid, it will be on race error. If it's okay, it will be generate new error and put new string in the method. So we can use library in Clang and like use this method, and it's example of this generation. So we see that a lot of data will be generated for this method, and we see some error when we put some volume, and it's pretty easy to test your function when we should work with different data. sorry. So it's our general test. We put some value, check some delete value, check and other. So how it can be refactored with fuzzer. Sorry. So we can use macros like we call some function and then we check if it's empty, no empty, and if it's not empty, call next function, then check and next function. So it's pretty convenient when you should test a lot of data and different data, and also you can choose which type you will be test. So next topic was about different architecture, task flow, about seasonal patterns, expressions, concurrency, some network changes in C++ 20, and introduction to Microsoft Fuzzing platform 2. So how it will be, how it's was similar implemented in Microsoft about fuzzing testing. So we have the cloud platform that you can test the fuzzing in cloud. You can visit the repository for more documentation and how it works. So we see that we create several containers for fuzzing testing. We can see status of the testing, and we can get a report of each container and see each report for each container and how look report. So it's example of report, and we see an executable file when we use some executable file, and we see call stack and some other logs that help to analyze what happened. It can be integrated with GitHub. How to return some error when we something fail? So we can just copy paste from GitHub the command in the, and repeat in locally, and we see that something was broken when we put some data, and we can analyze what was wrong. So It was just a few presentation, not all presentation. I decide like in short explain what was, and all materials you can find in official GitHub repository. It's a lot of these all slides, and you can also find videos in official channel CPCon. Also, you can visit official site. And next presentation will be next year in October. So if you're interested, you can visit, and I hope it will be offline. Also, thank for your time. Do you have any other question?
Thank you. It was very interesting. There are a lot of useful tips and tricks. For example, it was really strange to know that constant error values are allowed in C++.
There was a lot of topics about context and other improvements of C++. Thank you, because just new standard. So if you don't have questions, thank you for your time.